He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Okay, let's try a question relating to spontaneity. Consider the conversion of limestone to lime. So we have calcium carbonate, CaCO3, yielding calcium oxide, CaO, and CO2 gas. The values of delta H and delta S are 179.1 kilojoules per mole and 160.2 joules per Kelvin, respectively, at 298K and 1 bar. Assuming that these values do not change with temperature, what is the temperature above which conversion of limestone to lime will be spontaneous? So, we need to know some things about Gibbs free energy, enthalpy, entropy. We need to know how those values correlate. We need to know something about the conditions within which a reaction will be spontaneous. So, go ahead and check out my tutorial on Gibbs free energy if you need some review, and when you're ready, give it a try. So the first thing we have to remember is that reactions are spontaneous when delta G is less than zero. So we need delta G to be negative in order for a reaction to be spontaneous. So if we have delta G equals delta H minus T delta S, and we need delta G to be less than zero, then we also need delta H minus T delta S to be less than zero, because those are equivalent. Now, because we're trying to figure out the temperature above which conversion of limestone to lime will be spontaneous, that means we're going to be solving for a temperature. So let's rearrange this inequality to solve for temperature. All we do is add T delta S to both sides and then divide by delta S, and we get T is greater than delta H over delta S. So we can just go ahead and plug in the values that we know. Now we have 179.1 kilojoules per mole for delta H, but our entropy value has joules. So these are going to need to agree. Let's just go ahead and multiply this one by 1,000. That way we'll have it in joules. So 179,100 joules per mole. And then we can divide that by 160.2 joules per Kelvin. That way the joules will cancel. And we end up with 1,118 Kelvin. So that means that despite the enthalpic unfavorability, we see that this is endothermic, right? 179.1 kilojoules per mole. This is an endothermic reaction, which we typically expect to not be spontaneous. However, it is entropically favorable. We're producing more substances. We're producing a gas. Therefore, if we raise the temperature high enough, that T delta S term will outweigh the delta H term, and it happens to be this value, 1,118 Kelvin. Above that temperature, this will be a spontaneous process.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.